Hi guys, it's Nitro99 again doing a new Ninjago review. Django, I just didn't know the new movie Django on Jane and then Ninjago. I felt like saying it. It's Ninjago, of course. This set is called Garmatron, and I believe it's $40. I mean, Canadian, I don't even pay attention to Canadian prices, but it's something like that. And I think it was more expensive in Canada. I think it was like 50. I don't know. Anyway, so I went to the Lego store because I saw that the online store had them in stock, including much other stuff. So I go there, and this is the only set they had, which really disappointed me because, upon, you know, when I first saw the pictures of this set, I thought, well, that looks pretty strange. And I didn't really want it. I mean, I was going to get it, but I wasn't really excited about getting this or building it. However, it seems Ninjago really, Lego likes to troll me, because I actually kind of like this set, to be honest. It's a lot, I'll tell you why, but anyway, it's 328 pieces, comes with three minifigures, the ninja of the group, Zane, he's different. He has this chi sword. I'm not sure if this is supposed to glow blue or something, but anyway, and then you get a flunky who just dies, and you get, this big fellow, Garmadon's cousin, I believe, named Kozu. On focus. Kozu. Garmadon's cousin. Yep, extended family. So let's start with the box. It's a little peculiar in that it says the final battle here. And it's I don't think it is, because Ninjago is continuing. And before we thought it wasn't continuing, but it is now, and I guess what's the next wave has robots in it, but I guess they're gonna be fighting there. It won't be the final battle. Maybe this is the final battle of Garmadon. I don't know. Maybe the final wave of Ninjago will be part Chima and part Ninjago. Because, you know, everyone who likes Ninjago likes Legends of Chima, of course. So Lego's probably gonna, you know, put a fast one on us. Up here is prominently displayed Lloyd, there's some green accents there, and he looks really pretty cool there, to be honest. Ninjago, the box, it looks pretty big on the box, but when I build it, I think, oh, and of course it always looks big on the box, but it's actually going to be really small. But it isn't, it's actually very big. There's another, it's usually, you know, is automatic, I think, oh, it's going to be small, but and then it isn't. So there's four things to collect this time. It's chi swords. You know, I think Lego Ninjago is definitely ripping off Chima of this one, since Chima uses chi, and now Ninjago's stealing that idea. And here's Sensei Wu with a really creepy face, telling you to go to this website. Oh, and then the play features is a prison. Lloyd is in prison because he has a dumb vehicle. UFO cockpit, and a little movie. Well, I don't know what that is. That looks pretty cool, though. It doesn't look like this. I think that's really vintage. I mean, there's missiles and stuff. Apparently, it shoots purple missiles. Anyway, two manuals. The first one is a small one. Just gets the figures and this little dumb thing. This little cockroach mobile. And the big one. This is bigger. I believe there is a... here. The other sets. And I called I asked the guy at Lego Store, and they said maybe next weekend they'll have the rest in stock, so hopefully then. But there's six of them, and I want to get them all. Just because Ninjago is pretty cool, and it's really popular. So let's start with Zane, the robot guy. Honestly, this is a very strange... I mean, the vehicle doesn't make much sense. It's supposed to, like, do this. I mean, why does it have these here? It's supposed to drill into the ground. Is it a mining vehicle? And then it has this. It's like, is it supposed to be a laser thing? Is that supposed to attack? I don't think how that's going to be very effective against a bloody tank of a giant missile. But, and that has, like, energy thruster things here. It's a very strange thing. I don't know. It's just... I don't know what it's supposed to be. Maybe you can tell me if you watch the TV show. I don't know if this season is aired yet. But here is Zane. And Zane is looking very sharp. Has a new kimono-like tuxedo outfit. I mean, it's like an ascended master of ninja-ness. and he has this massive chi blade, which is ripped off from Chima, of course. You know, he's in a telescope thing. I think it's supposed to be blue, because, you know, on the back it has blue, and even on the box it's blue there. However, I think when I take it out of the box it's blue, but I don't know if it's supposed to react to body heat or water. It doesn't say anywhere, but so now it's just clear. I don't know what I'm supposed to do, really. It doesn't say in the instructions, I think. How is it supposed to get blue? So even there, it looks kind of bluish, you know? But it doesn't say anywhere. What am I... Maybe I'm supposed to put it underwater, or maybe I'm supposed to freeze it. It's pretty snowy outside. There's a foot of snow outside. Let's stick it in the snow. Because, you know, Zane is the snow ice ninja. But anyway, he looks fantastic. I think... I haven't seen the other ones. I mean, I don't really pay attention to the pictures, mostly because I want to be surprised when I open the box, because I usually remember everything. But he looks snazzy, and see his little insignia on the back. I mean, I just really like this figure. Even though I'm not the biggest fan of Ninjago, I don't watch the TV show. I just think he's good. His face is the same as it was. The hood is the same, but torso is very pretty, very pretty, pretty, pretty. So, I'll get another look at this. There isn't much to it. I mean, it's a lot. Interesting build. I had to rebuild this like 3-5 times because I just was not paying attention, which usually happens. But it looks like a bug, like kind of bug of some sort, a bug. But anyway, let's get rid of this and move on to the Garmatron, which I guess is a sentient tank. Maybe it's alive. It talks. It's called Garmatron, but it's like a robot Tron, you know. So I don't know. As you can see, it has a face, so maybe it is alive and talks, has feelers, or, you know, samurai spur things. Teeth, giant missile. The missile was rather brilliant, in my opinion. These giant treads. Let's see here. It works fine. You can't really lift it up because the missile. Oh my gosh, it broke already? Obviously didn't put that in properly. I have to put that back in because that's what fires the missile. So give me a second here. Nah, there isn't. It only has four connection points. So yeah, that will come off. And you can see back here. This is the missile thing. This is the prison, which since the bottom is, you know, hollowed out. It's not like Zane has to plan the great escape to get out of this thing. There's four stickers here, which I actually placed on rather well. I didn't mess it up too badly. Up here, it's, you know, very formidable. I mean, except for the fact that Kozu is like 20 feet tall, and he can get hit by a gun. I mean, it's actually pretty safe. More stickers up here. I mean, two of these on each side, and then this. These battery things, and then this is more chi from Chima. I mean, it looks just like it. I mean, I'm not trying to joke too much, but it actually does look like the chi thing from Chima. And I can't see much else. It's really cool to get, you know, the spokes and the treads. However, you know, the fact that it's in red is not very useful for mocking, because you don't usually have red treaded tanks. So I suggest if you want to do that, paint it. I mean, because you don't often get treads in Lego. And of course the purists will say that, hey, you're not supposed to paint it, it's Lego. Well, Lego's a toy, and if it makes a child happy to paint it and build something new, then go for it. Increases your creativity level. Anyway, so this guy, he doesn't even have a name, the poor fellow. He's nameless. He's just a flunky who, you know, shows up, then he gets spinned around and dies, and that's the end of his life. He's a pretty decent torso. I mean, it's generic, but has more of that chi in the middle. I mean, I don't know if Lego purposely is doing these connections. I'm just pointing it out. Has two giant scimitar sabers. He actually only had one, but I gave him the other one, since you get two. And his face is bluish. So you basically get gray, red, green, and a blue face. I don't really think it's going to show up. It's very dark. On. Almost there. Stay on target. Stay on target. No. Oh my gosh. I don't have an autofocus. It just has to kind of do it. It doesn't want to. Oh my gosh. Anyway, it's very bluish. It looks kind of weird. It doesn't really match his outfit. The red hat. Rice patty hat. And this is Kozu. Kozu's the big fellow. In the box, he has the chi sword, but they're supposed to give the chi sword to Zane. So Zane's supposed to get back the chi sword, then he gets trapped and captured because his vehicle sucks. Anyway, Kozu is a giant samurai guy. And he is quite brilliant, honestly. I mean, the only problem is it doesn't have back printing, so that does not work together. But the front has printing. And he has two torsos, if you didn't notice the fact that it has four arms. Leg printing. Torso design is very pretty. It's just a lot of silver. And his helmet, I mean, look, it is even pretty. It's a perfect, amazing samurai helmet. He's very red, though. His face is, look at that face. That one's focusing. It's not dark. Apparently my camera likes white people. So, Jesus. Anyway, his two katanas, which I'll take out of the way. I love his face, though. I mean, his face just looks so sinister. And I'm not sure what this guy's supposed to be. Anyway, but, so you put this torso on this. You cannot put the torso on the leg. I tried putting it on the legs, but it's not the same kind of torso, which some people don't knew that already, but I tried because I like to change minifigures. One thing that's interesting, though, I did this right away, is if you line up like that, you can notice that there's a slight tiny gap. It's not the complete length of a proper minifigure torso. But that's pretty much it, to be honest. Oh yeah, these are pauldrons, new pauldrons that are red. I wish they were a different color. Red isn't too much red in this. It's kind of getting obnoxious. I think that's it. Overall, I like the set. I mean, this set is really big. Like I said, I thought it was going to be small, but I mean, look, it's big. Here's another clementine or tangerine. What can I say? It's actually a very nice set. Oh, the missile. Oh my gosh, how could I forget the missile? So as you can see, you push this, and this is the good missile, you know, the one that really does damage, not that thick fire junk. Bam, it goes far. I mean, I don't want to shoot it across the room and have to go retrieve it in the middle of the video, but it shoots far. And for the small problem that bar will come unhinged like it did when I was reviewing it earlier, yeah, that's the only problem. But yeah, it's really fun. I'm sure kids are going to get a hoot out of shooting it at their mothers. Anyway, hope you had a wonderful New Year's, and hope you guys can get these sets, and hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you get some Legends of Chima as well, because I'm going to review some Legends of Chima and Ninjago. I don't know which is better. Because, you know, once you see Legends of Chima, maybe it is better than Ninjago. You never know. It could be a lot better. In fact, in a year from now, maybe Ninjago, no one will like Ninjago anymore, and Legends of Chima will be the thing to have. Well, that would be amazing. So what do you think about this set? Hope you enjoyed this review. Press like, comment, favorite, subscribe, of course, and see you guys later. Bye.